Copies of Prince Harry's new memoir went on sale in London just after midnight on January 10, 2023, with fans of the Prince outnumbered by members of the media at a branch of W.H. Smith in Victoria Station, which opened late, specially for the launch.
I want to hear his story in his words, because at this point, I feel like the British media are radicalising the British public against Prince Harry. Quite clearly, the UK media have sensationalised the parts that make him look the worst and sell them the most papers and create the most public outrage.
The publication has been accompanied by 4 television interviews in the UK and the United States, where he now lives with wife Meghan.
Everything is context, so I really want to see for myself what the true story is.
By the contents of Harry's ghostwritten memoir, which will be available in 16 languages and as an audiobook, have already been widely leaked after copies mistakenly went on sale early in Spain.
I think I expect to be able to read more about the truth of what goes on behind the palace walls. I feel like they are a notoriously secret family.
The book contains a claim from Harry that his brother William physically attacked him as they argued about Meghan, according to those who got their hands on one of those copies. It also gives an account of how he lost his virginity, an admission of teenage drug use, and a claim he killed 25 people while serving in Afghanistan with the British military, which earned him a rebuke from hardline Islamists, the Taliban. The family, particularly William and father King Charles III, will be fearing what other embarrassing and dangerous revelations are contained within its pages as the British media peeks over Harry's claims in minute detail. Queen consort Camilla also looks set for a rough ride after Harry used an interview with the US network CBS to take aim at his stepmother. In addition, after days of TV trailers and newspaper leaks, a relatively low figure of 4.1 million people tuned into the first of Harry's interviews with Britain's ITV, according to official ratings data. In the interview, the Duke of Sussex caused bafflement by insisting he and his mixed-race wife never accused the royal family of racism over comments made about the skin tone of their unborn son.